Your Excellency, Mahinda Rajapakshe, former President of the Republic, Honorable Chon Amaratunga, Minister of Tourism, Honorable Members of the Parliament, Your Excellency, the Chinese Ambassador in Colombo, the President and Distinguished Office Bearers of the newly formed Sri Lanka Chinese Culinary Association, dear friends, first of all, I extend my gratitude to Sri Lanka Chinese Culinary Association for the invitation you extended to me to attend to this memorable occasion. When I was invited, I was really surprised as to why I was asked to deliver a speech on the subject of culinary arts, because I am clueless on that field. My expertise not in the field of art of culinary, but in the field of eating food. Anyway, I wish all the success of your every endeavor you will make in the future. I have the confidence that your association will be successful and you will be able to go for a long journey, because at the inception itself, your association is being dominated by a female president. Our relations in between China and Sri Lanka are not limited to our culinary arts or the foods. It goes more than two millennia in our history. If you look at the world history, there are only seven countries which are having written history going more than two millennia. Sri Lanka and China are two of them. Our relations beyond 2,000 years is in the written history, when Buddhist monk Pahien, Chinese people call as Bhikkhu Pahien, visited Sri Lanka over 2,000 years ago in discovery of Buddhism. But now, of course, that our relations is not limited to religious aspect. Lot of industrial and business potentials have been developed during last several decades, but long before that, history reveals when China was successfully in operation of the Silk Route running over 6,000 miles, the Sri Lanka and China had a very strong and greater relations. Sri Lanka and China had taken sometimes revolutionary decisions against the international community. At the end of the Korean War, when there was a ban on China, the Sri Lanka was not hesitated to enter with agreements with the Chinese government, the famous rubber rice fact between China and Sri Lanka was one of the most controversial transactions in the world during that period. But of course, that there was about to have a dent in the relations between the two countries at the Bandung Conference held in Indonesia in 1956. But that relation had been fully restored during the period of Mrs. Bandaranaike, when Sri Lanka was recognized as one of the greatest leading country in the world. Among the non-aligned countries during that era, Mrs. Bandaranaike built a very close relationship with the Chinese people and the Chinese government. As a result, they built the iconic building in Colombo, BMICH, as a grant from the Chinese government. During the recent past, of course, that there had been many transactions in different fields. Now these initiatives to make aware the people of the importance of the development of culinary arts. Although your compeer said that the Chinese rolls are very tasty, when you go to Chinese hotel or a restaurant, you can find everything else other than Chinese roll. But they are available only in Sri Lanka, I think. Similarly, in every corner that you can see, there are Chinese restaurant, but you will never be able to find Peking duck. With all that, we know that there are authentic Chinese food restaurant, many restaurants in Colombo doing very successfully. At the same time, as one of the earlier speakers said, that there are Chinese restaurants in Colombo than Beijing. I think it's high time. There has to be a system to monitor, because there are so many Chinese, fake Chinese restaurants which are not authentic, and also which can cause a lot of health hazards since there is no proper standards and hygienic level maintained. I think that is a matter to be taken seriously by Sri Lankan health authorities. I am not going to take the pain that your compeer took, because he had to keep on talking until the VVIP are present. But here my job is easy, that so many speakers are lined up to address you in this memorable gathering. I also was really impressed with the speech delivered by the very beautiful young lady from German who is involved in the cruise industries. I think that if you will be able to help this beautiful island and this nation by converting several cruises to this island too, where then they can enjoy not only the authentic Sri Lankan food, but also authentic Chinese food in Sri Lanka.